Welcome, viewers. This is Elimu TV, the station where you watch and learn. I'm Mr. Mwangi. I'm taking you through chemistry form 2. And today we are going to discuss about the structure of an atom. We are going to look at the first 20 elements. So by the end of this lesson, you will have achieved the following goals. So please pay attention. So what are the goals of this lesson? By the end of this lesson, you'll be able to achieve the following. Illustrate the atomic number and mass number using the symbol of an element. State the first 20 elements in order of the atomic number, and you'll also be able to draw the structure of given atoms. So, composition of an atom, just a reminder, has got three subatomic particles, protons, neutrons, and electrons, within their given location, nucleus, and within the energy level where we have the electrons. Atomic number, we said in our previous lesson, is the number of protons. And mass number is given by the sum, the mass number is the sum of protons and neutrons. So how do we represent this? In a given element, which we must know the symbol, for instance, now, in this illustration, X, that's where we write the element of the symbol. And A superscript, that's where we give the mass number, which is the number of protons plus the number of neutrons. And the subscript Z, where we have the atomic number, that is the number of protons. So that's how basically we illustrate or demonstrate or write the mass number and atomic number of a given element. So for instance, we can look at the following example, calcium. Calcium is atomic number 20. You can see where the 20 is. It has a mass number of 40. That is 20 protons plus 20 neutrons. Mass number of 20. And its symbol is Ca. Remember, we must have the correct symbol. Another example is sodium. Scientific name, natrium. Hence the symbol, Na. Atomic number 11. But it has a mass number of 23, that is 11 protons and 12 neutrons, giving a total of 23, which is its mass number. Lastly, we can look at another example, helium. Symbol is Ha, atomic number 2. Therefore, you can see where we have the 2 atomic number. And mass number 4, 2 protons plus 2 neutrons, giving us 4. And the element's symbol is indicated there, He. You can try and light the symbol of given elements. Now we know how we represent this, but now how easily can we remember the first 20 elements? There is a simple mnemonic that we can basically look at, which we simply sing, "Hey Helen, listen BBC News on Friday night." By so saying, we have illustrated the first 10 elements whose symbol is indicated there. So, hey, Helen, that is hydrogen and helium, listen, lithium, B, beryllium, B, boron, C, carbon, news stands for nitrogen, on oxygen, Friday night, that is fluorine and nitrogen. That is the first 10 elements. We also have a Sudanese magistrate arrested 6 people suspected of committing a crime, and that became a police case. So by so saying, we have illustrated from sodium, magnesium, aluminium, silicon, phosphorus, sulfur, chlorine, argon, potassium, and calcium. So you can basically use that retro trick to remember the first 20 elements. The first 20 elements are labeled, or we number them according to the atomic number. Therefore, hydrogen, atomic number 1, all the way to potassium, atomic number 20. But there are several characteristics that we can give there. For instance, element, symbol, proton, which is equivalent to the number of electrons, neutrons, and the sum of atomic, the atomic number therefore gives, or is the number of protons. Therefore, we have this column similar to this one, which is also similar to this column. But mass number is the sum of protons and neutrons. Basically, you can add this to column, neutrons and atomic number. There you have got the mass number. What about the structure of these atoms? First, we need to remember the following. Electrons revolve around the nucleus in regions which we referred to as energy levels. The first energy level can only accommodate a maximum of 2 electrons. That's what we refer to as duplet rule. Dup meaning 2. The second, third, and fourth energy levels for the first 20 elements can hold a maximum of 8 electrons. That's what we refer to as octet rule. We need to keep that in mind for us to draw the structure of atoms. So, hydrogen. How can we draw the structure of hydrogen? We start with the nucleus, where since we don't need the composition, we have the symbol H at the nucleus. That's standing for hydrogen. The first energy level has got one proton. That's a proton there. That's an electron, because electrons are found within the energy levels. Then that's how the structure of hydrogen atom looks like. Second element, helium. How is the structure of helium? Start from the nucleus with the symbol He. The first energy level, helium is atomic number 2, 2 protons, which is equivalent to the number of electrons. Therefore, we have 2 electrons. That's how the structure of helium looks like. We also have rhodium, atomic number 3, nucleus with the symbol. The first energy level has got a maximum of how many? Duplet rule, don't forget, 2 electrons. But rhodium is atomic number 3. Therefore, it has 3 protons, equivalent to 3 electrons. Therefore, the third electron must be accommodated in energy level number 3. So, can we draw the structure of sodium? First energy level, we start with the nucleus with a maximum of 2. The second energy level with a maximum of 8. And the outermost energy level with a maximum of 1, since it is atomic number 11. So, let's see whether we have achieved the goals of this lesson. Explain what you understand by the terms duplet and octet rule. Then, draw diagrams showing the structure of chlorine atom and light its representation, showing its atomic number and mass number, and you'll be good to go. Your tutor, Mr. Mwangi, stay tuned to Elimu TV.